was that shooting on Laurel, where I was grateful, and you could really see that people were excited that Officer Lopez and Officer Cabrera, after they could leave the situation there, they came and responded to the people. And they were excited that there was police officers there. So I want to thank Officer Cabrera and Officer Lopez for being good community public servants. Thank you.
Thank you, Tony. Okay. All right. Okay, a couple of things. I want to announce a couple of appointments just because I know there are folks who are interested in some aspects of the changing of council members and various committees that folks will be serving on. So I have asked, and Gloria has agreed to continue as mayor pro tem, and I appreciate that. Thank you, Gloria. Councilmember Barrera will be on fora, so Tony will be doing that. I actually know that one, Forward Reuse Authority, for those of you who have that question. Councilmember Lutz will be on the serving on the Solid Waste Authority. Councilmember McShane will be doing AMBAG duty along with the Air Board. And then Kimberly Craig will be serving on LAFCO. An important new assignment will be the Redevelopment Advisory Group. Councilmember Sanchez and Councilmember Craig will be serving on that. And then on the Old Town Board, council members McShane and Craig will also be serving on that. So there will be other appointments, but those are a couple of the highlights for folks who, as council member Sanchez alluded to, there's a little bit more to all this than we show up, you know, as 32 or 33 Tuesdays a year. There are commissions and committees that are important and that the community follows. So those are some immediate changes that I want to make the community aware of. And then I also want to let the council know, if they don't already, I think they probably saw this in their packet, but I also want the community to know that Georgina Mendoza is leading a group as part of our White House initiative. They are now in Boston. Deputy Chief McMillan is there. Gary Vincent from I think it's Adult Alternative Ed is there, and then Elliot Robinson from the county, the head of what is his department? I know it's Social Services and Employment too, right?
Yes.
Those four now are currently in Boston at the federal government's expense. The part of the program that we're involved in with the other six cities is cities visit other cities for the purposes of learning and sharing information. Boston was, by most accounts, where Operation Ceasefire was first successfully implemented. They also have some very good data sharing and intelligence information that we think is important and of value. So I think it's an important trip. They're going to bring back good information. So I do want to make the community aware of that. We continue to execute against plan on all levels: enforcement, prevention, intervention, et cetera, and seeking to maximize our collaborative opportunities with our state and federal partners. So I want to make everyone aware of that. And with that, we will go ahead and jump to the consent resolution calendar. There are six items on the City Council agenda, three items on the Redevelopment Agency agenda. Would any member of the council or agency like an item pulled? Councilmember Lutz.
I just want to make a quick comment on 3, 4, and 5, and I can do them all at the same time.
I'm going to let you do them all at the same time. Okay. Anyone else? Councilmember Barrera.
Also, 3 and 4.
Okay. All right. Anyone else? Public. Back to council. Al, which one? 5? That's a 5. Okay. All right. Very good. We will, Jill, I'll let you proceed, and then followed by Councilmember Barrera, and then followed by Al.
I just wanted to very quickly thank Elizabeth and her staff for working so hard to get grants. And you have really just been wonderful in looking under every stone to find every dollar that you can find. And you stretch those dollars as far as you can. So I wanted to thank you, Elizabeth, for making sure that you got those. Congratulations to you and your staff and for the reports. Appreciate it.
Okay, Tony.
Yes, Mr. Mayor, if I may, I have a question for Ms. Martinez. As far as these grants, and by the way, congratulations on your good work. But I as I was reading this report, I noticed that you mentioned the Alisal Union School District. I mean, it's a sad report as far as the reading problem within the students there, and it surprises me. I mean, this is not good. My question is, now that you're putting these after school programs for literacy, are you going to be working with the it's always great to have mentors and hire staff to help the children read, but I think the collaborative effort, which is critical to me, is, are we working with the Alisal Union School District?
Yes, Councilman, we haven't consistently worked with them. For you recall that we gave library cards to everybody and all K through 12 students in Salinas, and we started with Alisal because you and the superintendent brought that to our attention. We continually go back to all the schools at the beginning of the fall and give them the new kindergartners cards. We work with the high school librarians. Also, these three grants will actually support the homework center and provide a reading specialist. That's something we haven't been able to do before. So with the Tanamora Family Grant and the Dunce Grant and the State Library Grant, that's $103,000 to support literacy programs, primarily at the Cesar Chavez Library. The adult and family literacy is also at the John Steinbeck Library at the Literacy Center there. We work with them as we can. They are more structured and with a curriculum, and we're drop-in services. We have some computer literacy classes, but most of it is drop-in services. And the premise for family literacy, as you well know, is that if we teach the family, if the mother knows how to read, the children will learn how to read. And that's why those state library family literacy grants are so important.
Yes, and Ms. Martinez, I think the importance here is because the money eventually will go away. My concern again is because these children go to the Alisal schools. So I would like to see, even if I can assist you in this, where they know what we're doing at the library. This way, somehow we can work, because I'm sure that they have tutorial services as well. How we can maximize this effort, I think it's critical. So again, congratulations.
And I want to make sure that Mary Ellison, our literacy manager, and Margarita and Imelda and all of our staff, they deserve the credit. They work with the literacy staffs and the students every single day. So thank you.
Okay, thank you, Tony. And Jill, Al, before we go to you, just a point of clarification from Jill.
Yeah, I just wanted to just clarify that Tony, your comments are well taken, but I think we also need to recognize that that some of that information is a bit misleading. We really need to scrutinize the data in those testing. They're not really a real reflection of how well the kids are doing because of, obviously, because of language background and other indicators. But it does say that we do need to be very aware of children, and reading levels are critical. As speaking as the reading specialist at my school, we just have to be very careful and aware of it. But I don't think that we should take this information with a grain of salt.
Well, Mr. Mayor, if that's the case, then we shouldn't report something that's not true here, because there's no way we can take it as a grain of salt, because to me, this is a fact. It's a written report here. So I would, if somebody's going to write something, especially from a school district, I would like to hear the correct numbers, because this is really bad.
I think I probably misled you, Tony. I'm sorry. What these are, I'm sure the scores are accurate. But I think that what we have to scrutinize is the fact that many of the children that were taking the tests are Spanish language only students, and they're taking tests in English. So it's very difficult for kids to really, for us to get a real accurate snapshot of where they are if they're in bilingual programs. So that's all.
Yeah. Okay. Al?
Good afternoon again. My name is Al Espindola. I also wanted to congratulate Elizabeth for these grants. And I wanted to speak on five, the literacy grant, because I personally know a family that's benefiting by, will benefit by this and also by what they've been doing in the past at the Cesar Chavez Library. In regards to the father, he's never been able to read English. He speaks it and writes it to a certain level, but he's excited that besides his wife also learning to write English, he will be also be benefiting from the classes provided through Elizabeth. So I'd like to thank her and her staff for moving forward with this, and I think it's a great day for Salinas when we can all write English. Thank you.
Okay, thanks, Al. Okay. With that, I will
move approval.
Look for a second.
Second.
All right. Ann, you want to call for the question?
Councilmember Barrera?
Aye.
Councilmember Craig?
Aye.
Councilmember De La Rosa?
Aye.
Councilmember Lutz?
Aye.
Councilmember McShane?
Aye.
Councilmember Sanchez?
Yes.
Mayor Donahue?
Yes. All right. With that, we will proceed to a public hearing item. And Tara, I'm going to make a special request that we go as fast as we can, as slow as we have to, as fast as we can, as slow as we have to do the public's business in light of the folks who are here. We want to find that balance, and I know you can help us.
I'll talk.
So
fast.
With that, hi Tara.
Hi, Mr. Mayor and members of the council. Today we're here to consider a land use and circulation policy map clarification. I'm not doing well on the going fast part. It's not working. Technical problem, sorry. Probably no battery. So I guess you could just put it to the next slide. All right. Our general plan was updated in 2002. As part of that update, we updated all the mandatory elements, inclusive of the land use element and the land use and circulation policy map. The purpose of the land use element essentially is to describe the present and planned land uses and the relationship to the community's long-range goals for the city. As part of that process, you also evaluate the general distribution, location, and extent of land uses for future planning purposes. The land use map is considered general because it's called a general plan. As technology has gotten more efficient, it's gotten a little bit more parcel specific. However, it's still considered to be general. As part of the update, one of the parts that was addressed was various areas of the city called future growth areas, and those are areas of the city where planned growth is going to occur. As part of the general plan update, there was a requirement for specific plans to be prepared prior to any development in any of the future growth areas. The land uses that were shown on the land use map are basically illustrative of potential land use scenarios that could be shown in that area. Could you go to the next slide, please? Here's the land use map. As you can see, I'll kind of use my little pointer here. The future growth areas, you can kind of see these areas in here the land use configuration is more bubble oriented. This is the rest of the city, the interior portions of the city. You can see there's streets and reflects more parcel boundaries and whatnot. But in the future growth of the areas where subdivision of land hasn't occurred, the land use configuration was more estimated based upon the land use capacities envisioned for those areas and call out a general layout of the potential land uses in those areas.